Do you want to create your own website and learn how you can do that? Certainly you could, but after this course, keep watching. Hi everyone, I hope that you are doing well and everything perfect. Who see me first time, my name is Alil Amri and welcome to my channel. This video will be the starter for our course, which I call it web development. Today we will code a new web page from the beginning to the end as a home page for our suggested website. Now I'm going to open the Visual Studio Code. Actually, I recommend it because it is simple, easy to use, and effective in the same time. Check the description below and you'll find the link to download it. Here we go. It opened up nice platform which has many features. Now select open folder. This folder will be our work zone. I had created it before. My advice to you is making this structure for your project, then create the files. Okay, firstly I create a new file, I'll call it index.html. perfect. In the editor, just type html and choose the html5 from the menu. Great. Now we have HTML code and HTML file. This part for web page header, and this is the body of the page. The body shows the result of HTML tags. Yes, here the result will be. Okay, let's try something. For example, P. Yes. Okay. Now, this is the result. Okay, this code for navigation bar or website top menu. And the second part will be under the nav bar. Okay, let's see the result. Great. Now I'm going to explain the code in more details. Navigation bar starts with the div tag. Inside div tag we use the hyperlink tag, image tag for view the logo. Let's see the result of this code. Yes, perfect. In the second part, we also use the div tags, and let's see the result. Okay. Yes, this is the result of the second part. In the head part, we need to call style sheet file for our page theme. Okay, just type li and choose link. Okay, here we have to write the path. I put the file in CSS and I call it style.css. Okay, let me see. Sorry, I forgot to create it. Now, style.css. Okay, now we have the file. This class for the body. Okay, we need top nav. Yes. Here it is, top nav. Okay, let's see the result. Nice. Now the hyperlink in the top nav. Okay, this hyperlinks. Okay, nice. Okay, this for top nav mouse hover. Perfect. Now top nav active class. Hyperlink active, sorry. Okay, that's the result. Great. And now top nav icon. Okay, let's see. Yes, here. Yes, perfect. Now the responsive part will be here for top nav. As shown, all top nav classes have been duplicated, with the only property which we need to change. Okay. Good. That's the difference here. Now we need to call this file for show menus icon in responsive bar. Okay, let's see how the responsive looks like. Amazing. This is our menu shortcut. To make the menu open and close, we need some JavaScript, if you never mind. This function called onClick property. The purpose of this function technically is to add responsive class to div with ID my top nav. That will happen when we click on the menu bar. Let's see the result. Okay, the function works properly. Perfect. Now we need to add responsive class to style file. This class makes the JavaScript function work properly. Okay. Here I have to delete this. Then the function will add it when I click on this bar. Okay. Perfect. The second part of our page starts here. We need to add pbackground class in the style sheet file. This contains the URL for the image. Okay, I put it here in image folder. Now small refresh will show us the new result. Perfect. Another class we have to add is container. Okay. To fix this problem, we have to add mainp text class. The mentioned class will view the photo full page. Let's see. Perfect. Now some touches for adding more beauty have been needed. Therefore we need to add 3 or 4 classes relevant with the mainp text class. First one, and the sets effect. The second one for span. Okay, perfect result. Now the third one will be for the register button. Yes, here. Let's see the result. Perfect. The last one will be for mouse hover. Let me see. Brilliant. This part also needs responsive property. This fork container. Nice. Everything work properly. In spite of that, we need to consider the small screens. So the solution is adding a new media screen for small devices in responsive part. That means we have to tell the interpreter max width for the small screen to adapt the view for. Let's see. Okay, that was for 6-inch mobile phone. And some classes for the smaller screens. Let's see the final results. Refresh. Brilliant job. Everything work properly. Okay, my friends, the lesson is finished. If you have any questions, leave a comment. Don't hesitate. To download the source code, check out the description box below. You'll find a link for that. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Goodbye.